Thursday, October 5th. I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy with your tropics update for the Atlantic Basin. That's the Gulf Caribbean Sea and the Atlantic Ocean. We have two disturbances with no names out there. One closer to the coast of Florida, the other way out in the open waters of the Atlantic near the Azores. Those are not likely to develop, but we're watching Nate, which developed into a tropical storm this morning. Winds of 40 miles per hour, the pressure down to 999 millibars, and this system continues northwest at 9 miles per hour. This system's center is now over land, over Nicaragua, continuing to push to the north towards Honduras. We're seeing some shower and storm activity, of course, on the eastern side of the system, where we're seeing that interaction with the water, so keeping the convection going this morning. And indications we could see a little bit of an eye wall developing as well. So certainly seeing some features indicating a stronger system, which will continue to likely happen in the coming days. We're looking at tropical storm warnings right now around Nicaragua and Honduras. Also a hurricane watch in place for the Yucatan, in addition to the tropical storm warning as well, as those conditions will continue to go downhill because the system will continue northwest and likely strengthening. Steady strengthening expected in the next 24 hours. So by Friday morning, 7 a.m., looking at 50 miles per hour with those winds. By Friday evening, 65 miles per hour as the center's system approaches the Yucatan Peninsula. It could be inland at this point, but it also could be over the open water. So this is something we'll have to keep a close eye on because water will lend itself to stronger potentially system, and also the land interaction could mean a limited system in terms of intensity. As we get into late Friday night, early Saturday morning, the push over the Gulf of Mexico, and that's where we see this system likely becoming a Category 1 hurricane. Forecast track update, which was a big story this morning, is that the National Hurricane Center forecast track now shifted way to the west, and notice the New Orleans area, all of the WDSU viewing area included in that forecast track. Now the system tracks a little bit more to the west. We still have some concerns as we'll be on the eastern side of this system, and actually we could see some stronger potential of winds and maybe some severe weather. If we're on the if the track shifts more towards the Florida Panhandle, we'll still have some direct impacts. So let's just prepare for this system, as we'll likely see impacts into the weekend. This is Sunday morning, 7 a.m. winds of 80 miles per hour, so that's a small uptick in intensity, but still keeping it at Category 1 hurricane status by early Sunday morning, then continuing inland across the southeastern United States. And here are those forecast ensemble models as well. You can see that far-reaching system and those remnants moving into the northeast through Tuesday morning. Looking at the upper-level wind shear, where you see the colors, that's where the wind shear will be. Notice, however, with the track of Nate, we're going to see lower wind shear around these areas, and so that means the system could get itself together and get a little bit stronger. What will also lend itself to this strengthening will be the temperatures and the open waters. We're looking at middle and upper 80s, so plenty warm over the Caribbean Sea and also over the Gulf of Mexico. Coastal flood advisory was set to expire yesterday, but now with those potential impacts, the National Weather Service in New Orleans extending the advisory through Sunday for tides of 2 feet above normal through Friday and 3+ feet above normal through the weekend. So let's keep this in mind, of course, as we still have those breezes kicking in. Our winds will kick up as well through the end of the week. And of course, as Nate gets closer, we have that higher potential and probability for some stronger winds. Tropical storm force winds of 39 miles per hour and higher. So notice into Saturday afternoon, but roughly a 10 to 20% chance we'll have some stronger winds during the afternoon. But you'll notice the winds kicking up as we get into Saturday evening. This is 9 o'clock, and right now at a 40 to 50% chance of some of those stronger winds from the coast and then pushing inland across the metro area. And then as we get into late Saturday night, early Sunday morning, a higher probability of those winds. So we'll have a better chance to sort of time out the best chances for the winds to kick up. But this is the broad stroke right now, the broad brush. Looking at the hurricane force winds right now, that probability is low at this time, but this certainly could change in the coming days as well. Rainfall forecast showing that as potential to be on the higher side. 1 to 2.5 inches through Saturday night. We'll add on to that through Saturday night and early Sunday morning through the afternoon. So by the time we're all said and done, some spots could pick up between 2 and 5+ inches of rainfall through the weekend. We also have a risk for some stronger storms around the Florida Panhandle and also over portions of southern Alabama. Again, if the center of the circuit circulation moves over our area, they'll be on the eastern side of the system. So that's where some of those stronger storms could be. However, if we see a shift of the track more west of the New Orleans area, we'll be on the stronger side. So this is something we have to consider as well. Here are the takeaway points for Nate. Let's be prepared. That's the number one thing. Make sure those hurricane kits are in order. Our weekend impacts are likely to happen for us, increasing potential for direct impacts as we continue to watch the latest forecast evolve and come in from the National Hurricane Center. Potential impacts include elevated tides, winds, surge, and heavy rainfall possible. That's the latest right now. Of course, we'll keep you posted online at WDSU.com, and all day through the afternoon, you can catch Chief Meteorologist Margaret Orr today at 4 o'clock.